शर्मा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ गायनियो, फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथिक साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट नॉर्मल लेबर। सो स्टार्ट नॉर्मल लेबर विद नॉर्मल लेबर। फर्स्ट इज डेफिनेशन। Definition: series of events that take place in genital organ in an effort to explain the viable product of conception out of the womb through the vagina into the outer world is called normal labor. So first is series of events that take place in the genital organ in an effort means bearing down effort by the mother, effort to explain the viable product of conception out of the womb through the vagina into the outer world is called normal labor. So this is definition. Before complete the 37 week completed weeks is called preterm. Week completed, this is called the term, and before the 37 weeks completed is called preterm. Now some terminology and uses during normal labor. First is parturient. Parturient means a woman who in labor is called parturient. Parturition is the process giving of the live birth. It's called parturition. Third is delivery. Delivery is not synonymous of labor because delivery can occur spontaneous or with minimal aids or without aids, or maybe abdominal like cesarean section. So delivery is the expulsion or extraction of the fetus, either vaginal delivery or abdominal. So This is the terms for uses in the label. Now, criteria of the normal label. Normal label is called a normal when it fulfills some criteria. First criteria of normal label. There are five criteria. First, it should be spontaneous in onset and at term. Term is the complete 37 week. Before 37 week we call preterm labor and after 37 week we call postterm labor. Second criteria of the normal labor is without undue prolongation. Vertex presentation means cephalic presentation. So, vertex presentation of the baby. Fourth is natural termination. Without having any complication to affect the health of mother or the fetus or baby. So, without any complications, this is five criteria of the normal labor: spontaneous on onset at term. Second is undue prolongation, without undue prolongation. And third is with vertex presentation. Fourth is natural termination with minimal aids. And last and final five is without having any complications to affect the health of mother or baby. So this is five criteria of normal labor, and we call normal labor also Eudosia. Eudosia. Now, abnormal labor. Abnormal labor is also called dystocia. Of normal labor is called the abnormal labor, means dystocia. When the definitions is the series of events that take place in the genital organ in an effort to expel the viable products. So any deviation in the normal labor, definition of the normal labor is called the abnormal labor. labor pain. Differentiation in the fast labor pain and true labor pain. First is fast labor pain. This is dull in nature. Especially in primary gravida. Primary gravida means a woman who first time in conceive or pregnant. Second is irregular contraction. Third is no dilatation of cervix. By enema or sedatives or any spasmodic drugs. Or anti spasmodic drugs. Next is true labor pain. True labor pain is regular contraction. And the intensity, frequency, and duration of contraction. Are increased with the progressively means according to time is increased, the frequency, intensity and duration of contraction is also increased. Third is this is true labor pain by the dilatation of cervix. Fourth is associated with show. So what the means of show? Show is that cervical mucus plug mixed with the some blood cells. This is called show. Cervical mucus plug mixed with blood. So associated with show. And fifth is the pain is not relieved by enema, sedative or anti-spasmodic drugs. So this is about true labor pains and false labor pains. Now we discuss next process or mechanism of labor in next class. Thank you.